So welcome back dear students. Today we are going to discuss on the numericals of the losses in pre-stress. So first question, you can see here, question number one, you can see a pre-stress concrete beam of rectangular cross section 150 mm wide and 300 mm deep. It is 150 mm wide and 300 mm depth is pre-stressed by 8 high tensile wires of 7 mm diameter. It is having a pre-stressing wires of 8 numbers 7 mm 5, located at 100 mm from the soffit of the beam. That is, it is located, the CG of this is located at 100 mm from the soffit of the beam. If the wires are tensioned to a stress of 1100 newton per mm square, that is P naught is equal to 1100 newton per mm square, calculate the percentage loss of the stress due to elastic deformation, assuming the modulus of elasticity of concrete and steel as 31.5 and 210 kilonewton per millimeter square respectively. So you are asked to find the loss due to elastic shortening. So you have the loss due to elastic shortening as what? Is equal to the loss, or the loss in stress due to elastic shortening, I can write it as loss is equal to M into FC. That is, M is modular ratio and FC is the stress in concrete at the level of steel. So we need to find the value for this FC and M. So here the given things are the area of 8 steel wires of having 7 mm diameter is 8 into, this is pi by 4 into 7 square, this is the solution. So pi by 4 into 7 square, you will get this as 308 mm square. Now the pre-stressing force P is equal to P naught into 308 mm square, that is, you will get this value as 338 kilonewton. Now the cross sectional area is 150 into 300, that is 45,000 millimeter square. The moment of inertia, that is I, is equal to B d cube by 12, you will get it as 33.75 into 10 raised to 7 millimeter raised to 4. The modular ratio represented by M is equal to Young's modulus of steel divided by Young's modulus of concrete. It is given as 210 divided by 31.5, so you will get the modular ratio as 6.66. Also, they given the eccentricity. Now it is, the neutral axis is over here. Neutral axis is over here. So it is given, it is having, or the diameter of the bars are at a distance of 100 mm from the soffit of the beam. So from here, if I am taking, it will be 50 mm. This is geometrically, it is not to the scale. So please excuse. So eccentricity is 50 mm. Now we need to find the value for FC. FC is the stress in steel, stress in concrete at the level of steel. Either you can find the average stress or you can find the stress at the end. End will do. So if you are finding the stress at the end, you don't need to consider the load of the beam. You don't need to consider the dead load or live load of the beam. Either for more accuracy, you can go for finding the dead load and then the average. But here we'll go for we'll follow the textbook by N. Krishnaraju and NPTEL. So there we are taking directly the stresses at the end. So if I am drawing here, I need to draw the stresses at the level of steel. Then it will be, I am having the concrete like this. The pre-stressing force P is acting like this. As a result, the stress distribution, I can get it. There will be a direct stress P by A, which is positive. And due to this pre-stressing force, it is going to bend like this. So the tension at the top and compression at the bottom. So I'll be getting tension at the top and compression at the bottom. That is P into E. Now it is, FC is the stress in concrete at the level of steel. At the level of steel means I need to find at this level of steel what is the stress corresponding. This is the level of steel. I need to find this value. What is this value? This is FC. This value is total. This is FC1, FC2. This is FC. FC1 plus FC2. So I need to find the level of stress in concrete at the level of steel. That is, here I can write it as, this is directly P by A plus, this is also positive, this is negative, so here also it is plus. At the level of steel, this value is what? This is E, that is 50 mm. So if I am writing this value, this value is equivalent to P into E, that is the moment, into the, this is not now YB, this is again eccentricity E by I. This is a considered fiber, the fiber is at a distance of E. So I could write P into E into, that is moment, into E by I, that is the distance from your neutral axis, that is E. So I can write FC as, here the stress in concrete at the level of steel as P by A, that is FC, I could write it as FC is equal to P by A plus P into E, that is the moment, into the distance of the steel considered or level considered, that is, that it is a distance of E from the neutral axis, divided by I. So if I am writing this value, I'll get it as, this value I'll get it as, this is P, here is 338 into 10 raised to 3 divided by area, here is 45000 plus P into E, that is 338 into 10 raised to 3 into E is 50 mm into 50 divided by BDQ by 12, we will get it as 33.75 into 10 raised to 7. Solving this value, we will get this value as 10.02 Newton per mm square. This value, you will get, this is 10.02 Newton per mm square. So which means this is equal to the stress in concrete at the level of steel. Now loss of stress due to elastic deformation is modular ratio into FC. And now modular ratio is ES by EC, you got this value as 6.66, that is 6.66 into 10.02, that value you will get it as 66.73 Newton per mm square. So that much is the loss of stress due to elastic deformation. Now the percentage loss is the current loss divided by total available, that is 66.73 divided by the total availability was 1100 in percentage, that is into 100, you will get this as 6.06 percentage loss. So this much loss has occurred to this concrete due to the pre-stress due to elastic deformation. Now you can see the next question. Question number 2. A rectangular concrete beam 300 mm depth and 200 mm wide is pre-stressed by means of 15 5 mm diameter wires located at 65 mm from the bottom of the beam and 3 5 mm wires located at 25 mm from the top of the beam. If the wires are initially tensioned to a stress of 840 Newton per mm square, you are asked to calculate the percentage of loss in steel immediately after transfer, allowing for the loss of stress due to elastic deformation of concrete only. So again, you need to find the loss of pre-stress due to elastic deformation, but here the wires are being provided at bottom and top. So if you write here a rectangular beam, here, this having 200 mm depth, sorry, width and 300 mm depth, 300 mm depth is pre-stressed by means of 15 5 mm diameter bars. 15 5 mm diameter bar, this is 15 5 mm located at 65 mm from the bottom of the beam. So this distance I could write it as 65 mm and 3 5 mm bars. So here also there is somewhat at the compression side, there is 3 5 mm and it is located at a distance of 25 mm from the top of the beam. This is 25 mm from the top of the beam. If the pre-stressing are initially tensioned to a stress of 840 newton per m square. That is your P naught. I could write it as P naught. I could write it as 840 newton per mm square. 840 newton per m square. Calculate the percentage loss of stress in steel immediately after transfer. That is, we need to find again the elastic shortening of the stress due to the elastic shortening. Since the top bars are distributed above and below of the center of gravity, the losses are calculated for top and bottom separately. So please note, we are calculating the losses at the top and bottom separately. Here also you could assume the ES as 210 kN per Newton per mm square into 10 raised to 65 Newton per mm square, and EC as 31.5 kN per millimeter square. That is, I will write similar to previous question. It's not given here. If it is given, you could take this value. Otherwise, we can take the value as EC is equal to 31.5 Newton per mm square. If nothing is given, you can assume ES as 210 Newton into 10 raised to 5 Newton per mm square and EC as 5000 root FCK. If the FCK value is given, both are not given, you can assume these values. Now, we need to find the position of the centroid of the wires from the soffit of the beam. That is, these two wires are there. We need to find at what is a centroid. So if I'm taking from the soffit of the beam and taking y axis from here, y bar from here, then y bar, I could write it as y bar is equal to a1 y1 plus a2 y2 divided by a1 plus a2. Since here it is same bar diameter, I could take it as the numbers, because pi by 4 into 5 square will get cancelled. So I could write as 15 into 65 plus 3 into the distance from here to here, that is 300 minus 25, that is 275, divided by 15 plus 3, and get this distance as 100 mm. So the centroid of these two bars is at a distance of 100 mm. So eccentricity, I could take it as this total, the centroid is acting somewhere here at 100 mm. The neutral axis of the beam is at 150, and the eccentricity due to these two is at a distance of, is acting somewhere here, and this distance is 100 mm from the soffit of the beam, which means the eccentricity I could take it as 50 mm. Eccentricity I could take it as 50 mm. That is, eccentricity is equal to 50, 150 minus 100, that is 50 mm. So now we could go to the equivalent to the similar previous one. That is, now we will find the area of concrete. The second moment of inertia, that is BDQ by 12. Pre-stressing force, that is pre-stressing stress into 18 bars, 15 plus 3 into area of 1 bar, that is 5 mm diameter, you get it as 300 kN. Now we need to find the stress in concrete for both the cases, that is for number of bars at the top as well as bars at the bottom. So at the top level, or at the level of top wires, I could write stresses in concrete at the top wires, level of top wires, I could write it as, so if we go here, you can see this. If I am drawing the stress due to this, due to the top eccentricity, I will be getting, this is going to have a direct pre-stressing force like this, that is P by A. Now we will consider the eccentricity of below here. Since this is below, we are going to get the deflected shape, or due to this pre-stressing force, it is going to get deflected this way. That is, tension at the top and compression at the bottom. So I am getting here the tension, that is negative at the top and compression at the bottom. So if I am drawing, this is my level of steel. At this point is my level of steel, and here bottom, this is my level of steel. I need to find the stress over here, 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 and here for both bottom and top separately. So at the bottom I will get P by A minus P into E. That is P is here given into E is the eccentricity into the distance. That is 125. That is 150 minus 25 divided by area. That is and divide by I. That is 45 into 10 raised to 7. So at the top I can write this is P by A into P into E. That is into 50 into the distance for your considered fiber, that is at a distance of 125 divided by I, and for the bottom I have P by A, this distance is P into E, that is 50 into the distance, that is this distance I could write it as 150 minus 65, that is 85 divided by I. So that is the stress at the top and bottom. So if you come here, I can write the stress at the top, we could write it as top wise is equal to 300 into 10 raised to 3 divided by 6 into 10 raised to 4, that is the area, minus 300 into 10 raised to 3 into the eccentricity 50 into distance, that is 125 of the fiber considered, divided by 45 into 10 raised to 7. You'll get this value as 0.83 Newton per mm square. Similarly, you have the stress at the level of bottom fiber as you have, that is 300 into 10 raised to 3 divided by 6 into 10 raised to 4 plus 300 into, because there is compression at the bottom level, 10 raised to 3 into 50 into the distance, that is 85 divided by 45 into 10 raised to 7, you'll get this value as 7.85 Newton per mm square. This value is 7.85 Newton per mm square. Now, subsequent loss in stress at the top and bottom, that is we need to write the loss in stress at top and bottom. Top, we will write it separately. Top is equal to the stress at the top fiber, modular ratio in the stress at the top fiber, that is modular ratio is 6.68 into 0.83, that is you will get this value as 5.55 Newton per mm square. Correspondingly, the percentage loss in stress at top is equal to 5.55 divided by 840 into 100, that is you'll get this as 0.66%, and correspondingly the loss in stress at the bottom, loss in stress at bottom, you could take it as 6.68 into 7.85, you will get this value as 52.5 Newton per mm square, and the corresponding percentage loss in stress at the bottom steel is equal to 52.5 divided by 840 into 100, you will get this value as 6.25%. So that is the loss at the bottom and top fiber when you are considering the bars at the top and bottom. So if it is coming like this, we need to find the eccentricity at the midspans and find the stresses at both the level of steel considered. Now the next question is for a post-tension concrete beam. So last one was for pre-tension, last two were for pre-tension. Now a post-tension concrete beam 100 mm wide and 300 mm deep is pre-stressed by three cables each with a cross-sectional area of 50 mm square and with an initial stress of 1200 Newton per mm square. All the three cables are straight and located 100 mm from the soffit of the beam. If the modular ratio is 6, calculate the loss of stress in the three cables due to elastic deformation of concrete for only following cases: simultaneous tensioning and anchoring of all the three cables, successive tensioning of the three cables one at a time. So here you can see it's given A post tension concrete beam 100 mm wide and 300 mm depth. This 100 mm and this 300 mm deep is pre-stressed by three cables each with a cross sectional area of 50 mm square. That is, this total area is 150 mm square. This is 150 mm square with an initial stress of 1200. That is, P naught is given as 1200 newton per mm square. All the three cables are straight and located at 100 mm from the soffit of the beam, which means the eccentricity is, this is 100, so eccentricity is E is equal to 50 mm. If the modular ratio is 6, calculate the loss of stress due to elastic deformation for concrete, which means due to elastic deformation. So here in this question, the force in the cable is equal to 50 into P naught, that is, you get the 60 kN. This is for each cable, okay? I am considering for each cable, that is 50. Now area is equal to given as, the area is 100 into 300. You will get the moment of inertia BdQ by 12 as 20 into 5 and raised to 6 millimeter raised to 4. Eccentricity is 50 mm. And Y, that is the level of steel considered, that is 50 mm. Stress in concrete at the level of steel we have calculated, that is, we will get it as similar to what we have done, that is 60 P by A plus P into E into E. This is E because we are considering the level of concern, this distance, this is E and this is the level concern, that is Y, P into E into E. Here Y is equal to E divided by I, you will get it as 2.7 Newton per mm square. Now we will start with the first case. It is simultaneous tensioning and anchoring of all the three cables. Then in such a case, under simultaneous case, that is case A, you have under simultaneous tensioning and anchoring of all the three cables, there will be no loss due to the elastic deformation of concrete, because we have studied the theory, if it is simultaneously done, there won't be any losses. Now when the cables case B, as I have mentioned, when the cables are successively tensioned, that's one at a time, the first cable is tensioned and anchored, there will not be any loss, because as we have discussed, the first cable is tensioned and we will anchor it here, there is no loss. Now when we are tensioning the second cable, there will be some loss, we will be anchoring here, there will be some loss delta L, we need to find that one. So when the cable 2 is tensioned and anchored, loss of stress is happening in cable number 1, that is, this cable number 1 will be having loss of stress, and that value we need to find out. That is, here the loss in stress will be what, here in the cable 1, the loss of stress in cable 1 is, I can write it as loss of stress in cable 1 is equal to M into FC we have calculated, and M also we know, that is 6 into 2.7, that is 16.2 Newton per mm square is the loss in stress in cable 1 when cable 2 is anchored. Now we are coming to cable 3 is tensioned. When cable 3 is tensioned, there will be loss in cable 1 as well as, because here when cable 3 is tensioned, cable 3 will be like this somewhere here. Is tensioned, there will be, we will be anchoring it over here. That is delta L, another delta, this if I am calling delta 1, this one delta 1, delta L2 will be there. That is, there will be loss delta L1 plus L2 for cable number 1 and delta L2 for cable number 2. So the tensioned and anchored loss stress in both cable 1 and 2 is given by loss in cable 1 is equal to, when this is considering when only cable 3 is tensioned, that is this delta L2, I can say this is delta L2, that is loss in cable 1 is 6 into 2.7 and loss in cable 2 is 6 into 2.7, that is for cable 2. So the total loss due to elastic deformation of concrete in cable 1, I could write it as cable 1, it is delta L1 plus L2, that is 16.2 plus 16.2, that is 32.4 Newton per mm square, and cable 2, it is 16.2 Newton per mm square, and cable 3, it is 0 Newton per mm square, because this is what we have said in the theory, there will not be any loss in cable 3. So average loss in stress, I could take it as 32.4 plus 16.2 divided by 3, that is I'll get it as 16.2 newton per mm square. So that is the average loss in stress. So average loss in stress considering 3 cables is equal to 32.4 plus 16.2 divided by 3, that is 16.2 newton per mm square. That is the total loss. So the percentage loss you can calculate accordingly. So this is the numerical corresponding to elastic shortening of concrete. We will discuss the remaining ones in the next class. Thank you.